Shri Guruvayo Namaha students, welcome to online class. Today I am going to discuss exercise 6.5, question number 5, right? In that I am going to discuss absolute maxima and absolute minima. Already we saw local maxima and local minima. Whatever it is, the first step is derivative. You want to find the derivative, right? Now you see exercise 6.5. Find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value of the following function in the given interval. Here first subdivision you see f of x is equal to x cube, where x belongs to the interval -2, 2. Right? Strictly increasing, strictly decreasing, increasing, decreasing, and then finding the slope of the tangent, local maxima, local minima. Then now we are enter into the absolute maxima and absolute minima. Whatever it is, the first step you want to find the derivative of the given function. That you keep it in your mind, children. Yeah, now I'm going to move to the solution. F of x equal to x cube. What is the derivative of this function? Anyone, you have to participate. Yeah, very good. 3x square. How you arrive the result, children? Anyone, a boy or a girl, you should give a reply. Yeah, very good. You are applying the derivative of x power n, right? On and off, you have to recall the formula, right? Now, the second step, what do you want to do? You have to equate the derivative to 0. F dash of x equal to 0. This is your first step. This is your second step. Now, 3x square equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 0. This one we call it as critical point. How we name it as? It is a critical point. X is equal to 0 is a critical point. Here you have to check whether the critical point is exist in the interval or not, right? In the previous we didn't have. In the previous what you people did, local maxima, local minima means, you have to find the second order derivative. In that second order derivative, you substitute the critical point. Here you don't want to do this. You have to check the critical point is exist in the given interval or not, right? Now you see the critical point is exist in the interval, children. Yeah, it is exist, right? X is equal to 0 belongs to the interval -2, 2. Then you have to substitute the critical point and the end points of the interval in the given function. To find absolute maxima, and minima, right? Absolute maxima and minima, substitute critical point, and the end points of the interval. End points of the interval means what? -2, 2. End points of the interval in the given function. End points of the interval. -2, 2 in the given function. Right, children? I hope you people understood. Again, I repeat, you see, first step you have to differentiate the function. Next step, you equate the derivative to 0. Then you should check whether the critical point is exist in the interval or not. The third step, to find absolute maxima and minima, means the critical point, substitute the critical point and the end points of the interval in the given function. In that, if it is highest, that is absolute maxima. If it is lowest, that is absolute minima. That's all, right? Now, at x is equal to 0, the critical point you are substituting in the function. At x is equal to 0, f of 0 is equal to 0. At x is equal to minus 2, f of minus 2 equal to minus 2 the whole power 3, which is equal to minus 8. At x is equal to 2, f of x equal to f of 2 equal to 2 cube, which is equal to 8. Here, which is absolute maxima and which is absolute minima? Absolute maximum is 8. Absolute maximum value is 8. Absolute minimum value is minus 8. Right? I hope you people understood or not. Right? Absolute. Simple it is. Absolute maximum value is 8 at x is equal to 2. Absolute minimum value. Absolute minimum value is minus 8 at x is equal to minus 2. Right. Now I'm going to move to the second subdivision. Right. What it is, second subdivision, trigonometry function, it is interesting, right? Now, second subdivision, f of x equal to sine x plus cos x. Here, what it is given, you see, x belongs to close the interval 0, 5. First step, what I told you to do, you have to differentiate. Yeah, very good. Sin x cos x minus sin x, right? Now you have to equate with 0. The second step is what? You have to equate with 0. Now you see f dash of x equal to 0 sin x. Or what we got, cos x plus, right children, cos x minus sin x equal to 0, which implies sin x equal to cos x, right? Now, tan x equal to 1. How I arrive tan x equal to 1? I shift cos x to the left side. It will come under the division sine by cos equal to 1, then it becomes tan x, right? If you want, I will write it here. Sine x divided by cos x equal to 1, which implies tan x equal to 1. Now, what is x? Which implies x is equal to pi by 4. You have to check whether it is exists in the interval or not. 0, pi. The next step, you have to check the critical point whether it exists in the interval or not. Now, x is equal to pi by 4 is a critical point. Is a critical point, right? Now, how to find absolute maxima minima? Substitute the critical point and the end points of the interval in the given function. Substitute critical point and the end points of the interval. Now you see, at x is equal to 0, f of 0 is equal to sine 0 plus cos 0, which is equal to 1. Now next, at x is equal to pi by 4, x is equal to pi by 4, f of pi by 4 equal to sine pi by 4 plus cos pi by 4, right? What can you get? 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, which which is equal to 2 by root 2, which implies f of pi by 4 equal to root 2, right? See your children, 1 minute, I will erase it. That thing I don't want, right? Now you see f of pi by 4 is equal to root 2. Root 2 value is what, children? Ah, very good. 1.414. Right. Now, x is equal to, what do you want to do? X is equal to pi, 180, right? X is equal to pi because the critical, end points of the critical is what? 0, comma pi. X is equal to pi. F of pi is equal to sine pi plus cos pi. Sine 180 degree is 0. Cos 180 degree minus 1. This is equal to minus 1. Therefore, absolute maximum value is what? Absolute maximum value is root 2 at x is equal to pi by 4. Absolute maximum value is root 2 at x is equal to pi by 4. And absolute minimum value is what? Absolute minimum value. Absolute minimum value. Absolute minimum value is minus 1 at x is equal to pi. Right? Again, I repeat, children. First step, you want to do the differentiation. Second step, the derivative equal to 0. Then you find the critical point, you arrived, right? You have to check whether the critical point is exist in the interval or not. Then the third step, the critical point and the end points of the interval, you have to substitute in the given function. If it is the greatest value gives you absolute maxima, the lowest value will give you the absolute minima. The third and fourth one, you should do it as a homework. Right? Homework C and D. Right? Now I am going to move to the question number 6. Thank you, children.